In science, our chapter is going on, that is materials, metals and non-metals. And we already discussed about the physical properties of metals. The next topic is chemical properties of metals. So in chemical properties of metals, we have to discuss about reaction of metals with oxygen, reaction with water, reaction with acids, and then in the last, reaction with bases. So these are the chemical properties of metals. Means metals react with different substances like with oxygen, water, acids and bases, and react differently. So we have to discuss these properties, how metals react with these substances. So these are called the chemical properties of metals. So let me discuss these properties one by one. And the first is metal reaction of metal with oxygen, means how metals react with oxygen. Almost all the metals react or combine with oxygen and they form metal oxide. Means when metal react with oxygen, they form metal oxides. You can say the chemical equation, when metals react with oxygen, they form metal oxide. So you must remember, when metals react with oxygen, they form metal oxide. Means the substances, this chemical reaction, the substances before this arrow, this is the arrow, and the substances before this arrow, all the substances are called the reactant. Means the substances which are react together, they combine together, they are called the reactant. And the substances which is formed after combination, after the reaction of the some substances written after the arrow, they are called the products. So this here, the reactant are the metals and oxygen, and they, when they combine together, when they react together, they form the a product which is known as the metal oxide. So metals, when react with oxygen, they form metal oxide. Here are some examples, like when magnesium react with oxygen, when magnesium react with oxygen, it form magnesium oxide. Like that, when copper react with oxygen, it forms copper oxide, sodium oxide, and if iron, like iron, or react with oxygen, it form iron oxide. So there are some examples in this way the metals react with oxygen. Here this picture, when this is a iron substance, and when iron substance react with most air, it forms a brownish layer over it, and this brownish layer is known as the rust or the metal oxide or the iron oxide. So when what happens when iron react with the moist air, what happens when copper react with the moist air? So here are some examples. This is called the rusting of iron. Rusting of iron is nothing but when iron react with oxygen or water, that is means iron and water, that is the you can say moist air. So when iron is exposed to the moist air or left outside into the air, then it gets rusted or it forms iron oxide. This is the word equation. You have to remember this word equation into the symbolic form. Iron is represented by Fe. Fe is the symbol of iron. O2 represents the oxygen gas. Water, the symbol of the water is H2O. So here it represents the moist air, and when iron is exposed to the moist air, it gets rusted. So here this is the chemical formula for the iron oxide or the rusting. Not only the iron gets rusting, but other metals are also gets rusted. So like that, the copper is also gets rusted when it's exposed to the moist air. So when copper react with water and carbon dioxide and oxygen, it gets a layer, a green, you can see in the picture, a green layer. This is the copper vessel without rusting, and this is the copper vessel with rusting. So here it's a green coating is deposited over the this copper vessel. So it is known as the rusting of copper. So here, when copper react with moist air, this is the moist air, and when copper react with it, then it forms two substances that is known as the copper hydroxide and copper carbonate. So these both represents the rusting of copper. It is the chemical equation in the into the symbolic form. So you have to remember these word equations: rusting of iron and rusting of copper. Now the next question is, metal oxides are basic or acidic in nature? So metal oxides are basic in nature. Acids and bases, you already studied in 7th class. Substances are having the two types of nature, maybe they are acidic or basic. So metal oxides are basic in nature. So how we have to test this means metals are acidic or metal oxides are acidic or basic in nature. So simple, we use the litmus paper test. This is the litmus paper of red color, and you know, when red color litmus paper turns into blue, means when we dip a red litmus into a solution, into a chemical, and if it turns blue, then that substance, that solution must be basic in nature. And when a blue litmus turns into red, then that solution or that chemical must be acidic in nature. So here in a picture, as I shown, this red litmus when dip into this solution, it turns into blue. It turns into blue, so it indicates the metal oxides are basic in nature. So metal oxides are basic in nature. Like if you have magnesium, when magnesium burned into the presence of oxygen, it forms metal oxide, that is the ashes. That ashes are the metal, nothing but the metal magnesium oxide. So when we dissolve this magnesium oxide into water, when we dissolve this magnesium oxide into water, we get a solution. And when we check solution with the help of this red litmus paper, then that red litmus paper turns into the blue. It indicates that the metal oxides are basic in nature. So in the same process, you can check or you can test the other metal oxides also, like iron oxide, aluminium oxide, sodium oxide, etc. Next is non-metals, means how the non-metals react with oxygen. So when the non-metal react with oxygen, they also form the oxides. Similar to the metals, non-metals also react with oxygen and they form oxides. Like sulfur is a non-metal. When sulfur react with oxygen, it forms sulfur dioxide. When carbon react with oxygen, it also form carbon dioxide. Hydrogen react with oxygen, it forms water. That is also, you can say, it's a hydrogen oxide, but the common name is water. So again, the same question arises here, whether the metal non-metal oxides are basic or acidic in nature. As the metal oxides are, we already discussed, the metal oxides are basic in nature, and the non-metal oxides are acidic in nature. So again, how we have to check these non-metal oxides? So again, we will use the litmus paper test, and for this we have to consider a blue litmus paper, because when blue litmus paper turns into red, it indicates that the solution is a acidic in nature. So we have to consider a non-metal. When non-metal react with oxygen, like sulfur react with oxygen, it forms sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide is SO2. So when sulfur dioxide react with, means we have to check this sulfur dioxide is acidic or basic in nature. So when we first we have to form a solution, and then For that, we have to dissolve this sulfur dioxide into water. So when this sulfur dioxide, because sulfur dioxide is a gas, and when this sulfur dioxide mix or react with water, it forms a solution that is known as the sulfurous acid. And when we dip the blue litmus into this substance, into this solution, that turns the blue litmus into red, which indicates that this solution formed by this non-metal oxide is a acidic in nature. Similarly, you can observe or you can test this with the carbon dioxide, with nitrogen dioxide. They turns the blue litmus into red, which indicates the means non-metal oxides are the acidic in nature. Thank you.